There's a well-known story in the world of cinema about an early film made by the Lumiere brothers. Because the concept of film was so new, when Arrival of a Train at Lo Ciota was shown to audiences for the first time, it was said that people ran out of the theater in a frenzy for fear that the train would not stop and would plow right off the screen. 127 years later, the technological advancements of filmmaking have these students captivated by a train on a screen for much more complex reasons.
This is the first virtual cinema system in the St. Louis area, and it's got to be one of very few in an educational institution anywhere in the country.
But do you guys want to try
it? You can put it
on
the camera.
Put it on that camera.
Sure, how? Yeah.
This virtual cinema system utilizes advanced technology to create any setting or atmosphere and calibrates it to this LED studio wall as a soundstage. Basically, it allows a video to take place in any real or imaginary location.
You can shoot a sunrise scene inside a soundstage all day long. You can shoot a rainy day indoors. You can shoot a sunny day indoors on a rainy day. It gives you complete freedom of production. You can also shoot actors in an imagined environment. You can invent environments and so on.
A major production to utilize this technology was The Mandalorian, in which over 50% of the first season was shot with a virtual cinema system. And while these film and video production majors at Webster University probably won't be creating something as large scale as that, this technology is a recently added feature to the major renovations of the School of Communications production facilities.
Okay, so when I was an undergrad here, I'm lost right now. I don't even know where we are. The media center was this way. So what's happening here?
So this remodeling was a complete gutting of the building. So everything but the exterior envelope was demolished and pulled out and then reconstructed so that it could be purpose-built as a communication and media production facility.
The Sverdrup building was built in the 1980s, before Webster even had a School of Communications. As the field grew exponentially, they built a small TV studio and fashioned classrooms into editing labs, dark rooms, and a media center. So now, through this remodeling process, students no longer have to squeeze into makeshift studios, but have access to more intentional production spaces.
So technology has helped in a lot of ways. It's also raised the question, everyone with a phone is a filmmaker now. You know, everyone can go on YouTube and learn how to program a game. How has that, affected enrollment?
I believe one of the reasons we've seen growth, everybody wants to tell visual stories, and young people have more facility with visual stories than earlier generations did. But you may not be a master storyteller yet. Right? We all speak English. That doesn't mean we're all best-selling novelists. So we can take those native skills and shape them into professional skills. So this is an immersive sound system. There will be 19 speakers in here.
Wow.
It creates a full 360-degree, a spherical sound field.
So all of this, just the process for this room, there's a lot of money in this room, is what I'm saying. I mean, do you see the return on investment happening?
Absolutely. The facilities we're providing our students now mimic. They're designed architecturally and technically to mimic the kinds of workplaces they'll be moving into after they graduate.
Having these educational settings that resemble real industry workplaces especially makes sense with instruction from faculty members who continue to work in the industry.
So I'm still, even though I'm full-time teaching here, I'm still out there working. Just past summer, I worked on Hocus Pocus 2.
So now I'm working on a film, which I have a 3D actress.
Joshua Johnson and Uri Bohos are co-teaching the first class utilizing the virtual cinema system. And while most film and video production classes don't rely on a textbook way of teaching, this class is particularly flexible.
It's not like other programs where you have a selected
curriculum, and there's like a bunch of like tests you have to take and materials you have to cover. This is a process where everybody is learning, including the professors. It's completely experimental. My goals after I graduate, I think, are to get with some larger production houses, like with LED walls and visual effects and stuff like that.
I think that's really important for students to have a professional, their professor, to actually be there still working in projects, because as you can see, technology changes pretty quickly.
Things are kind of changing to the point where in the future, it will be very interesting to see like what is what. It's pretty uncanny.
For Living St. Louis, I'm Brooke Butler.